Namaste. Welcome to another part of biochemistry where we will deal with the transportation of lipids. Understanding metabolism of lipids is dependent upon the understanding of lipid transportation. Triglycerides, as we all know, are nonpolar. They are the glyceryl esters of free fatty acids. Dietary lipids, they are rich in triglycerides. These are absorbed from the intestine. Blood transports the absorbed amount of triglycerides to other tissues. Now, what are these other tissues? The other tissues are liver, adipose tissue, and muscle. Liver metabolizes TG into various other lipids. Adipose tissue stores TG for serving and providing triglycerides as and when needed by the liver to metabolize. This happens in shortage of lipid content in the body. Muscle, as we all know, utilizes lipids and other nutrients to produce energy. The chemistry of lipids is such that the triglycerides are the esters of glycerol with three different fatty acid molecules. Being the esters of triglyceryl esters of free fatty acid, they are nonpolar. This diagram will show you the pathways of lipids from one tissue to another. They are essentially absorbed into the intestine, poured into the blood, which transports them to different tissues, to the liver, to the adipose tissue for storage, to the muscle for utilization. The metabolites of lipids are transported to the muscle for utilization into converting into energy through blood. Blood transports TG absorbed from the intestine to the liver for metabolism. Liver pours metabolized lipids, which are called other lipids, into the blood. Blood also carries triglycerides from the intestine for storage into the adipose tissue. In times of needs, these triglycerides are transported to the liver for metabolism. Blood can directly carry the triglycerides into the muscle for utilization. Here we will see what change occurs into the chemistry of lipids and why does it occur so that it can be transported by the blood to various tissues. As we all know, dietary lipids are only triglycerides. They are nonpolar. This figure here will represent a triglyceride having a small polar head followed by a long nonpolar chain. Whereas blood, the common vehicle for transportation in the body, is polar. Now we all know the rule of thumb for solubility is like dissolves like. Polar molecule dissolve in polar solvents. This difference in polarity of blood and the triglycerides presents incompatibility. Here the polarity of other lipids are useful. The other lipids are the lipids prepared by the liver from TG, such as, for example, phospholipid. Phospholipid is amphiphatic in nature, means it has got a polar head as well as nonpolar tail. This helps in carrying this TG absorbed from the intestine to other parts of the body. Their amphipathic nature facilitates transportation. How they are helping to transport nonpolar lipids to other parts through polar blood. It is very important to incorporate the triglycerides into the nonpolar triglycerides into some form so that they can be transported by the blood. This work is done by the amphipathic nature of other lipids. This diagram is of a typical lipoprotein. That is why triglycerides are converted into lipoproteins. Lipoprotein embed these relatively nonpolar triglycerides at the core, covered by a layer of other lipids. They are cholesterol, few molecules of phospholipids, and other form of lipids which have a polar head and nonpolar chain. The nonpolar chain embeds triglycerides and the polar heads are exposed to the blood. They also employ some apolipoprotein which are proteinous in nature. Hence, incompatibility is overcome by forming lipoproteins. These lipoproteins, they are composed of apolipoproteins, other lipids, and which envelop the triglycerides. Coming to the most important part of lipoproteins, there are five different forms of lipoproteins. They are: number 1, chylomicrons; number 2, chylomicron remnants; number 3, very low density lipoprotein; number 4, low density lipoproteins; and number 5, high density lipoproteins. Now, they have been differentiated on the basis of difference in their densities, because triglycerides are low in density than other lipids. Lower density represents non-metabolized lipids in lipoproteins, as well as higher density will represent higher proportion of metabolized lipids in the lipoproteins. Density of lipoproteins in the blood reflects the status of metabolism of lipids. If the metabolism is faulty, the density of non-metabolized lipoprotein will decrease, and that will reflect the defect in metabolism. Chylomicrons are the lipoproteins which embed TG inside other lipoproteins. The density is very, very low, lower than 0.95 mg per ml. Slightly higher dense particles are chylomicron remnants. These chylomicrons are prepared in the intestine as well, and they are transported by the blood to other parts. Very low density lipoproteins, which are abbreviated VLDL, are prepared in the liver. Here, the lipoprotein contains some amount of cholesterol esters, that is metabolite of triglyceride, and phospholipids. Hence, there is some variation in the density. They are higher dense than the chylomicrons. The density stays between 0.95 to 1.019 mg per ml. The other form of lipoprotein is low density lipoprotein, that is LDL. This LDL is a lipoprotein containing more amount of free cholesterol molecules, some amount of cholesterol esters, and phospholipids. Last form of lipoprotein is HDL, that is high density lipoproteins. It is densely populated with cholesterol esters. other part of lipid transportation is the form of apolipoproteins. Apolipoproteins, as we have seen, they are integral part of lipoproteins. These are polypeptides or proteins present in the lipoproteins. There are five forms of apolipoproteins. ApoA, abbreviated, they are present in HDL. ApoB, another form of apolipoproteins present in VLDL. There are two forms of ApoB, B100 and B48. B48 is a truncated form of B100, which is synthesized in the intestine itself, and hence it is basically present in chylomicron, whereas ApoB is synthesized in the liver, hence it is embedded in the VLDL. There are three isoforms of the protein ApoC, C1, C2, C3. They are smaller than the other apolipoproteins and they are found in all forms of lipoprotein. At times, they are also transported from one form of lipoprotein to another form of lipoprotein. ApoE is another form of apolipoprotein. They are also smaller and they are found in all lipoproteins. This part of lipids was abstracted from 20th edition of Harper's Illustrated Biochemistry. Thank you.